Brand new to Pinnacle Studio, you found the right place to get started. In the next 5 minutes, I'll take you through what you need to know to begin. To start a new project, click here. Let's gather the media you'll need for your video and put it in a project bin. We'll create a new project bin. And then you just import your files like this. To add our clips to the timeline, we'll simply drag and drop. Our project will automatically use the same video settings as the first media clip that we add to the timeline. To zoom in or out on the timeline, we'll drag the time ruler down here to adjust the zoom level. To play the clip, we can press the play button here, or just use the spacebar. Or to scrub through your project and find a certain spot, we'll use the scrubber and drag it along the clip. When we add a video with audio to our timeline, we can see the audio waves attached to the video. We can make adjustments to the existing audio track by opening the audio mixer by clicking this button. And then we can make adjustments to the volume of the track or to individual clips. Or we can mute the track entirely, like this, and add a soundtrack to another layer by dragging and dropping. To add titles, frames, or overlay videos, we can add them to the track above our main video on our timeline. To insert a track, right-click and then select Insert Track. Let's select and add a title. Then we just double-click that title to edit the text. We'll title this video Cycling in the Woods. Let's add a template now to make a cool effect on the video by selecting the Templates button here. And then drag that template onto the timeline. Double-click on the template, and we can drag and drop the media from our project bin to replace the placeholders. To trim the length of a video or template, you can move your mouse near the yellow boundary and just drag inwards. Or you can move the scrubber along your timeline to the points you wish to cut, and then either press the Split Clip button here, or N on your keyboard, to split your clip in two parts, and then you can just delete the part you don't want. If you need to crop, resize, rotate or reposition the picture on your screen, you can do so here. Let's make a couple of adjustments here to how the clip will appear in the finished video. We can also add transitions and effects. Click here to open the transitions library. Select a transition that you like and drag it to either end of a clip in the timeline. Position your cursor along the edge of the transition indicator, then drag it to change the duration of the transition. Now let's add an effect. Click here to open the effects library. Once we find the effect we want, we can simply drag and drop it onto the clip, just as we did with transitions. We can make fine adjustments to both the audio and the video of each clip by clicking here to open the editor panel. Here, we can adjust clip properties, corrections, and effects parameters, and much more. When you're editing, sometimes you just need more space. To work across multiple screens, you can always detach a window like this and move it across any of your displays to wherever you like. To pop it back in, we just press this icon again. As you edit, don't forget to save as you go along. To save your project so you can open your working file to continue editing, select File, Save Movie As. Once you're done with the editing of your video, we can select the Export tab. Select the folder you wish to save your final video in. Name your file. And then select to export with the same parameters of the original footage. or you can select to automatically export your video as a different file format, or optimized for specific devices. Sites such as Facebook or YouTube, and more. For more tutorials on features in Pinnacle Studio, visit the Welcome tab inside the product, or go to our YouTube channel at Pinnacle Studio Life.